I'm having a blast. So far, the fans are great, and the showmaster promoters really know how to put on a good show, so I think everybody's happy.
When fans do get to meet you, what are the most common questions you get asked? What do people always ask you about?
That's a good question. I get a lot of questions about Cabin Fever, about the leg shaving scene, how that was to shoot. I get questions about, as I was a Power Ranger once upon a time, so I get questions about that. Those fans are awesome and loyal and sweet, and they want to know every little detail about like the sets. And then a lot of inappropriate questions. But so far here, I feel like in London, everybody has a lot of manners, so not so many of those this time.
Well, keeping it appropriate, going back, I guess, to Power Rangers, what did it feel like to be part of a big global phenomenon like that? Because it was a phenomenon at the time and still today.
I mean, it was so long ago. You know, it was in really in the moment, it was just like any other acting job. I auditioned, I got the part, I was on a show, we worked our butts off. We worked a lot long hours. It was really fun to be part of. I didn't, while I was doing it, realize how massive it was. It was like the number one kid show in the world. So I would say that the most rewarding part of it is they did a lot of stuff with the Make-A-Wish Foundation. So we got to meet a lot of kids whose final wish is to be the Power Rangers. And so that was the most rewarding part. But at the time, I really didn't put together what it was. I was just like excited to have a job as an actress.
Of course, you mentioned their Cabin Fever, a film that has a real cult following. That scene in particular, people always ask you about. So they don't have to ask you again, can you tell us what it was like filming that scene?
The leg shaving scene was awesome. It turned out really well. They did a fabulous job editing it and all of that. And Eli Roth is a fabulous director. But it was complicated to shoot. It was technically complicated to shoot, like sitting on, you know, on an apple box in a bathtub, a fake bathtub. So it's cold water and... And like just the reveal of the prosthetics, K&B did the effects, so they were amazing. They were practical effects, so the reveal of that was, you know, it was like an emotionally complicated scene and a technically complicated scene. So together, it wasn't the easiest thing to shoot, but we got through it really fast, like 4 a.m. It was freezing, and they put it together really well.
Of course, it helps when you're working with a great talent like Eli. I mean, what do you think makes him such a special talent behind the camera?
It's just nobody like Eli Roth. He's extraordinary, unique. His brain works in a way that my brain doesn't. He's a filmmaker. You know, he's in the right business.
My final question, what are you working on next? Where are we going to see you next? That's what fans always want to know.
I have a film called Monica. It's an action revenge thriller coming out soon. Written and directed by Stephen Monroe. I'm platinum blonde in it. Shoot a lot of guns, so you should check it out.
You got a message for fans before you leave us?
Oh, just thank you for coming to see me and having me here. And as an actor, you get sort of stuck in your world in LA, like running to auditions and trying to get work, and then you get the work and you're on a set. And so coming to these things and actually meeting the fans, it's a whole different aspect of the business, and it's nice to see that that your work means something to someone, and it's interesting to have that interaction and like get their take on it, and it all makes us better.